Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Excuse me. Today we're going to talk about whack-a-mole. I don't know if you've all seen that game where they're moles, you know, obviously, pop out of the hole, plastic bang, and you hit them, and then you hit one, and then another pops up somewhere else, and you have to hit that. I don't know the purpose of the game, but I just saw it. When I saw it, it reminded me of what people do with room moles. They try to set their speakers up, set their listing position up, and try to avoid room boats. It's not a good game. It's not a good strategy. And let's walk through a few of the reasons. You can't position your out of modal issues because this is what they do. So you might have this situation where you have middle and high frequencies in the lulls that are peaked, and you might have other things going on in the dips of modes where there's no middle and high energy. So bottom is, you know, low frequency oscillation, and then you got your mid and high. You got two response curves, so to speak, to superimpose upon each other. So you might position yourself here and get out of the low frequency peak, but you're sacrificing something in the middle and high on an unusual situation. I've tried it. It's very, very difficult. You may miss one, but fall into another. Yikes. What are we doing here? You know, it's not good. It's like being out in an open field, dodging arrows. Well, you can only do it so long before you get hit. You might gain low frequent attenuation, but you're going to have problems with amplitude and other issues. Fix the fundamentals that are the cause. Every wall surface has a different frequency and amplitude of problem. Calculate the frequency and the amplitude of the problem. Apply the appropriate treatment to that wall. Some walls will have different treatment types. Some walls may have a starting modal frequency issue at 40. Some walls may have one at 30. So you treat with the proper technology that has those starting point resonant frequencies. That's how you have to do it. So each frequency and amplitude has a different strength on each wall. There lies the problem. So you might need 50 square feet of treatment on this wall at 40 hertz. You may need 80 square feet of treatment on this wall at 30 hertz. And we have that data, obviously only on our technology, because we've applied it for years and years and years, and we know what it's capable of doing, and we know what it's not capable of doing. But it has a pretty wide band range that it works very well in. Low frequency modes are mainly the bully in the room. They're the problem we're always trying to get away from. They're the jockeying for position, if you will. That's really what that's all about. So go after the low frequency energy. We have two products that can do that. Actually, we have three. We'll talk about those three. We have the ACDA series, the 10 and the 12. 12 is 30 to 50. The 10 is 30 to 300, really strong. Then they have our foam technology on the face, which extends their absorption range to 6,300, which, by the way, is the frequency response range mix engineers work in by design. And then we have our carbon panel for those people that just have 40 cycle and above issues. Not all rooms have 30 cycle problems. I would say half. Half are 30 and half are 40 starting point. The ACDA 10 and 12, 16 inches deep, the carbon panel is 12. So you don't have a 30 hertz problem, you don't need to lose 4 inches of space to treat it. And most rooms are small, so you have to be conscious of all that. The CAW is our really top of the line process for new construction. We do some retrofits. Doing a project now that we did 5 years ago, an electrician came in and did some faulty wiring and burnt the room down. So we're starting all over. But clients, not too upset because the insurance company's covering the damage, and we get to introduce, you know, all the changes we've made in the last 5 years in the technology. So he gets the latest and greatest. So the CAW is best because you build it right into the walls. You don't have any refrigerator style boxes, so to speak, sitting around, and you tune the problem every 14 and a half inches. Modes are 36 to 48 inches wide on average, so you go after those 36 and 48 inch problems every 14 and a half inches. That's how come we can guarantee very good response curves with our new builds. It's difficult with retrofits because we're not starting with proper dimensions, but on new builds we can. So positioning yourself away from modes, it's like playing the game of whack-a-mole. So we don't want to do it. We want to fix the cause of the problem, not run away or fight with it. Hope this helps. Thank you.
Thank you for watching this video. And if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to. So please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.